All right, so the third step of the solar project development process is the financing part, and this involves a power purchase agreement, or a PPA for short. So the actual definition of a power purchase agreement is just a contract between two parties. One party generates the electricity, you know, the project developer in our case sets up the solar panels, and the other party is just buying the electricity. Now for solar PPAs, this is usually a contract is signed that allows the project developer to build a solar farm or a solar energy system on the customer's property. A quick example of this would be a farmer who has a ton of land who wants to save some money. So they reach out to a project developer and they say, hey, build a 10 megawatt solar farm on my land. And the project developer comes out and builds it, handles the construction, the permits, connects it to the grid, all of that. And now the farmer, let's say they were paying like 15 cents per kilowatt hour for their energy. Now they do this PPA with the project developer, and now they might only have to pay 8 cents per kilowatt hour for this energy. Okay, so now back to PPA contracts. So these are usually long-term contracts that range from anywhere from 10 to 25 years. They come in the form of fixed price contracts, or they could have a yearly escalator, meaning that the price of the energy increases 1 or 2% per year. Okay, so there's two risky things to be aware of if you're the project developer. PPAs usually have one, a guaranteed construction and commercial operation date, and a guaranteed annual energy output. So if you have some of your permits that are taking longer than expected, this may push out your COD or your commercial operation date, and that might affect your power purchase agreement, and then you might be looking at fines or whatever the contract that you sign with whoever it is. So that's something to be aware of. All right, let's talk about timing. So most PPAs are actually awarded before you're done with the permitting stage, and that's because the power purchase agreement is such an important role in determining the profitability of your project. So you want to get that done fairly quickly, fairly early on. So you want to get this PPA done as soon as you can, but at a minimum, you're gonna want three things. Number one, you should have site control. So whether that means you bought the land and you just own it outright, or you're leasing the land. Either way, you have it figured out and you have site control. Number two, you want clarity of the costs of interconnection. I'll talk more about that in my next video, but generally you just want an idea of all the costs associated with your project before you move forward with this PPA. Lastly, you want a definitive timeline of when you're going to reach that COD or commercial operation date. Now, sometimes these PPAs can get pretty competitive, so you might be competing with other project developers in order to win this agreement. The key to winning a PPA is to present a project that displays a viable and realistic path to completing development on time, on budget, and that delivers energy at an attractive price, basically. All right, let's talk about some pros and cons real quick. So the biggest pro is that there's no upfront capital required for these PPAs. The second is that you'll be saving a lot of money on your energy bill. And if your farm is big enough, you could even sell some of that energy back to the utility company. That's called net metering. The third pro is that your energy prices are going to be very predictable. You know, it's a contract, so you know exactly what you're going to be paying. And last thing, you're not responsible for any of the maintenance or upkeep of the farm or of the energy system. The project developer handles all of that. All right, what are the cons? The cons are that you're entering into a long-term contract. You won't be eligible for any tax credits or tax incentives. And the long-term savings will be lower than if you would have purchased the system outright. Now, if you're thinking, man, those pros seem pretty enticing, you'd be correct. Power purchase agreements have exploded in the last 5 years, and there's pretty much no sign of them slowing down or stopping. And that's a pretty general overview of power purchase agreements. I'm not sure how I'm doing on time, so I'm gonna end the video here. And my next video, like I mentioned, will be about the interconnection process. For that video, I am going to try to find a big power line because there's one near my house, and I'll film the video there. I'll be back in Charlotte. I'm actually just on vacation in DC right now, so I thought I would film the video with this nice background near the Lincoln Memorial and Washington Monument. So I hope you enjoy the video. If you guys have any comments, if there's any professional solar project developers watching this, feel free to leave some comments. I'm always interested in learning more or if I misspoke at all. So thanks.